Hello there. Wow. Perfect. Wonderful. Well done.
Okay.
What's up, everybody? The Nintendo Beast here, jumping back into Animal Crossing Wild World here on the Nintendo DS. And today we've got, it's finally May, first of all. And we're signing on after 4 p.m. because there are two fish that we have to catch that become available in May. Well, so the koi is available year round, but they're only available between 4 p.m. and 9 a.m. So afternoon, evening, late at night, very early morning. And the same thing goes for the angel fish, which is like the polar opposite. So the koi, we're looking for a big ol' river fish, a big ol' river monster, and then an angel fish, a tiny little thing. Which, in fairness, I always thought when I was a kid that angel fish were like ocean dwellers. And maybe they are. Maybe either Animal Crossing has it wrong, or maybe they're both. But I definitely never thought there was like a freshwater ocean fish in existence, a freshwater angel fish. There are no freshwater ocean fish. That doesn't make sense. It's early when I'm recording this, so cut me some slack. I'm like half asleep, got my Red Bull. I'm actually time traveling a little bit. It's actually like 9 in the morning. I time traveled same day, but later in the day. That is a big old black bass. That ain't gonna do the trick for me here. It's beautiful. How much pocket space do I have? Oh, I am so good for pocket space. So the koi is a big shadow. I'm not sure how big. I should probably look that up. The angelfish is obviously a tiny shadow. And I believe it is indeed a river fish and not... Let me double check these things. Because right now I'm just going on things that I think I know. Let's see. The koi is a size 4 river fish. So the same size as like a carp. Are there any size 5s? Alright, so giant snakehead is a size 5 shadow. And there are size 6 shadows. So it's like a medium size. Medium to large, I want to say. And then the angelfish is actually not a size. It's a size 2. So it's not the tiniest, but it is small. See, these are things that I'm glad I just looked that up. Because I was thinking that it was like the largest shadow and the smallest shadow. But that is apparently just not the case. But it's fine. We're not seeing any fish, so it doesn't even matter. So that looks like a carp size. Come on, koi boy. Turn around. Are you really going to be a jerk like that? Seriously? We're playing this game? Seriously? You're gonna... How far downstream are you swimming? Oh, to a bridge. Good, yeah. I hate fish. Especially this fish in particular. I'm gonna say now that it's under this bridge, I'm surprised that it continued swimming downstream. Say, is it nibbling? Can't even tell. That is a shoe. After all of that, it was a freaking shoe, dude. Why? Are there actually ways of telling that it's trash before you reel it in? Because logistically, logically speaking, it makes sense that a shoe would float downstream and not go against the current at all. But I feel like I'm giving the game too much credit in that. I mean, I love Animal Crossing, so, you know, whatever. But I feel like the programmer, I feel like it's probably not actually programmed to disallow a shoe from swimming upstream. But in my mind, I feel like that'd be such a cool detail if it was the case. I don't think it's the case, though. I feel like I've definitely caught a tire going upstream before, or a shoe, or a tin can. If I can catch just one of these two desired fish today, I think I'll be pretty content. This guy looks pretty big. I would say this is a size 4 shadow. We got another shoe. Somebody let me know in the comment section below, does trash always float downstream? In game. I feel like I need to specify that. Come on, koi. That is a catfish. So to clarify, is a catfish size 4? It is. Okay, so I'm going after the right size. Just not getting the right fish. I also never thought koi were particularly rare. But what do I know, right? Hey, wait. Villager friend. Hi, who are you? You are adorable. Marina. Nice to meet you. Out for a nice evening walk, are you? Blurp. My name is Marina, and you are? Ah, yes, John. Well, hello. One night, you and I should go stargazing and see if we can spot cancer. Okay. I remember having the guide. Like, the physical, like, I don't know if it's Prima guide. It's like it was like the strategy guide for Animal Crossing City Folk on Wii. I don't remember what company. I don't think it was them. I forget what company actually made it. But I remember having it, and I remember having the full list of potential villagers in front of me. And Marina was always one that I really, really, really wanted because I thought she was adorable. And I don't think I ever got an octopus to move in to my town and City Folk. I think this might be too big. This is a rainbow trout. What size is a rainbow trout? Oh no, technically that's still a size 5, or a size 4, sorry. So in theory that was the same size. It just looked like a big size 4. Compared to the catfish I reeled in a second ago. Felt like that would have been a size 5 in comparison, but I do like Tipper too. This is Tipper, right? Yeah. I feel like let's chit chat. Lately, I can't seem to find anything I like when I check out the stories. The stories or the stores? I think it's the stores. I'm just not capable of reading at 9 a.m. Or breathing, apparently. Maybe I should ask Gracie to whip up something hot couture for me. Tipper was also one of my dream villagers, so I'm kind of... I have half a mind to, like, maintain friendships with a couple of villagers in this game and see if I can get them to stay. Such as Marina and Tipper. This has been a dud so far. This is a size 4, right? Swimming upstream, that's a good sign. Might not be actual garbage. No, it's garbage. Maybe not actual garbage, but it is indeed garbage since it just ignored my fishing line. Dude, I'm tired of this. Come back, fish. Alright, here we go. Let's go. Upstream. Alright, I feel like I have it cornered now. I don't, of course. I feel like I can't get out of this corner without seeing... It can. It can always get out of the corner without seeing your line. Even if it doesn't seem logistically possible, it's always possible. Come on, give me a koi. That is a black bass. I am over this, dude. I mean, maybe the koi is more rare than I'm giving it credit for, but also, I have not seen a single size 2 shadow this entire time. Not a one. So... Oh, this is a big boy, isn't it? Maybe not. Maybe a koi is an extra large size 4. Another rainbow trout. I'm filling pocket space relatively quickly. Stupid me, I was like, wow, just two fish? Maybe, because I haven't written down yet all of the bugs I still need to catch here in Wild World. So I thought to myself, oh wow, I might breeze through this, catch the angelfish and the koi really quickly, and then I'll have to look at my Critterpedia and actually like flesh it out for bugs, but not the case. I think at this point I'll be lucky if I catch either. That is a black bass. I think I'll be just lucky if I catch either one of these fish by the end of the episode. Say it's another rainbow trout. Okay. Let's not play games, shall we? It's a tire. So no... Trash confirmed can go upstream. That tire was definitely just swimming upstream. Would have been a cool detail. Like, for example, like when you go deep sea diving in future Animal Crossing games, how different, like fish are different because they're only differentiated between, by their, like their shadow sizes, not really their behavior styles. Deep sea creatures, you can actually like gauge whether or not it's something that you're looking for, potentially. It's not an exact science, but you can kind of gauge if it's something you're interested in by its behaviors. So, like, is it swimming? What's the shadow size? Is it moving at all? How quickly is it moving? That kind of thing. And I thought for a moment there, you could almost do the same thing with fish. There's a carp. And you could just eyeball it and be like, oh, that's only moving downstream. That looks like a piece of literal trash to me. But 'tis not the case. It's to Black Bass. We are halfway through this episode, approximately. And still have nothing to show for it. Except a blooming friendship between Marina and I. And a continued friendship between Tipper and I. Can we stop this little round and round that we're doing, Fish? Maybe you just come over for a nibble? There you go. So that must have been a size 3. I don't think a barbell steed is a size 4. Unless the range for a size 4 shadow is just incredibly large. Goes all the way from a barbell steed to, that could be a size 2, though. Nah, I think it's a size 3. Crucian carp. Wait, what size is a crucian carp? I hear somebody clapping for me. Barbell steed is a size 3. Crucian carp is a size 2. So apparently that is the size. Crap. I'm out of pocket space. Let me... This strikes me as a size 3. It's a shoe, dude. And what's worse is I have to swap it. I can't just leave trash around. I mean, I can, but it's like... Brutal. I was gonna say, Nookington's is still open, right? I think they are. I think they close at like 9 p.m. or something like that in this game. He says, oh boy. Oh boy, what do we have to deal with now? Bunch of trash. I was gonna take it to the recycling myself, but I'm gonna give it to you now. It's yours to deal with now, Nook. Take all the trash and the trash fish, but... $3,800. Rolling in the money. Rolling in the money. Alright. Alright, what are you? You size 4? Hey, calm down. How about you calm down? How about you calm down and come over for a nibble here? Oh, you. You. You're gonna be a jerk. I see you. Let's go. Black bass. Lame. Okay, let's continue. Continue on our koi quest. Our koi quest with a side of angelfish pasta. Angelfish. I don't know. It's too early for me to be witty. Leave me alone. Another black bass. Oh boy. Oh boy. Can't believe I'm going to go this entire episode and not catch a single thing I need. It's a real bummer. Wait, what size is this? Ooh, this looks like a size... I want to say it looks like a size 2, but it's definitely a size 3 at least. Probably a tin can. I've caught like 2 boots. What is that? Cherry salmon. Got like 2 boots and a tire. Feel like I'm just biding my time until I find a tin can. There it is. Oh no. Crucian carp again. So that one was a size 2. That Crucian carp. Confirmed. Not that it matters. I swear this fish was just... Oh, there it is, I was gonna say. It was definitely swimming over in this direction. Come on. Are you really gonna do this to me? I don't even know why I still ask. Turn around, fish. Fish. I hate you so much. I hate you so much, fish. A plague. Plague on all your houses. On all your schools. Fish. There it is. It's literally on top of you. Oh my god, is it a pond smelt? Oh, it's a dace. Dace in the hole. Which paste do I have left? Pockets are filling up quickly again. At least this time it's not with trash, but... It's only a matter of time. Like I said, I'm still... destined for a tin can. I think I literally just watched that fish over there spawn. Like, it just wasn't there, and then it just was there. And it might have just been, like, the wonky graphics of the water. But I think I just watched it spawn. I watched you come into existence, fish. Now come into existence in the form of a koi in my pocket. I think it's like a size 3. I don't even think it's big enough. That is a large char. Back in my day, well, not in my day, in every other Animal Crossing game, I'd be super stoked to catch a char. But not today. Not in Wild World, I'm pretty sure I've already caught plenty of char. But you know what I haven't caught any of? Koi and angelfish. What's up, Marina? Just know that if it wasn't you, Marina, I wouldn't be talking to anybody right now. Oh, hey, John, hang on a second. I was just trying to think up a good nickname for you, John. And I just thought up the best one ever. Want to hear it, Blurp? Tell me. I just love her little bow, too. It's adorable. Anyway. Okay, my friend. Prepare yourself for the most awesomest nickname ever. Bunny. Sure. You'll be Bunny to me, Bunny. Okay. That's fine, I suppose. Could be worse. Wow, it literally just swam right past my line. Nope. Another cherry salmon. What is this miserable life that I lead? Okay, wait. It's on the other side there. It's on the opposite bank. Hold on, hold on. Let me cautiously sprint on over there. Is it actually going to be over here, though? Yes, it is for now. These fish have a habit of, like, swimming to the other side, and then by the time you get over there, they're back on the side that you were just on. Come on, dude. Come on. Turn around. Upstream, bud. There we go. Come on. Nope. Nope. Gotta look at my line first. Upstream, but still paying attention to my line. Let's go. Where'd it go? Where did it go? Oh, okay, there it is. If I do it straight here. Nope, it swam right past it. Okay. Here we go. This is the perfect cast. Unless it decides to turn around, in which case, you know. Literally on top of you, literally on top of you. Hey, you saw it. What is that, a horse mackerel? Just kidding. Horse mackerel or ocean fish. It did look kind of blue and yellow, though, from a distance. But it was merely a dace. Wow, my success rate here is absolutely zero. I am 0 for 2 on both of the fish that I am hunting for. The koi is literally supposed to be available all year after 4 p.m. The angelfish May through, I don't know, it's a summer fish. But it starts in May, at least according to this fandom wiki. This is it, this is gonna be the koi. Here we go. Give me a koi. Ah, it's a black bass. What a surprise. What a surprise. Ooh, that's a big honker. I don't know what it is, but I'm going to catch it. This is definitely a size 5. At least I think it is. Oh no, it's a large size 4 rainbow trout, apparently. So size 4 definitely, if this fandom wiki is to be believed with shadow sizes designated for different fish, then size 4 shadows range wildly in size. Which doesn't make any sense why that would be the case, but Crucian carp. Oh boy, how much space do I have left? None. I have no more space left. Give me a tin can for good measure. How about that? One for the road. Some garbage for the road. Force me to throw back a real fish in favor of actual garbage. Well, it's close enough to actual garbage. Alright. Welp. That's that. Two full pockets full of fish, and not a single koi or angelfish to be seen. So I guess that's where we'll sign off this week here. Defeated. Deflated. A loser. A failure. Sad. I don't know. With that said, if you haven't already, make sure to subscribe to my channel here on YouTube, and ring that bell for notifications for when I do live streams here on the channel every Saturday, starting at 4 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, as well as when I upload new video content such as this every weekday, Monday through Friday of every single week. That also includes, on Fridays, I upload new videos, 5 new videos, every Friday. One new episode for each of the 5 ongoing Animal Crossing Let's Plays I have going. So all 5 of the main Animal Crossing games, each one has an ongoing Let's Play, and each one receives a new episode every single Friday. So you definitely, if you love Animal Crossing as much as I do, and if you just love Nintendo games as much as I do, you definitely want to be subscribed to the channel for all of that content. But also, if you like this video specifically, smash the like button on this video and leave me a comment in the comment section below. But until next time, I am the Nintendo Beast, being abused by Tom Nook, and I'll talk to you guys next time.